from the letter to the Hebrews. In the days when Christ was in the flesh, he offered prayers and supplications with loud cries and tears that the one was able to save him from death. And he was heard because of his efforts. Son though he was, he learned obedience from what he suffered. And when he was made perfect, he became the source of eternal salvation for all who obey him. Save me, O Lord, in your kindness. In your Lord, I take refuge. Let me never be put to shame. In your justice, rescue me. Make haste, deliver me. Save me, O Lord, in your kindness. Be my rock and refuge, a stronghold to give me safety. You are my rock and my fortress. For name's sake, you lead by me. Save me, O Lord, in your kindness. I'm afraid of the snare they set for me. For you are my refuge. Into your hands I commit my spirit. You redeem me, O Lord, faithful God. Save me, O Lord, in your kindness. But my trust is in you, O Lord. I say you are my God. In your hands is my destiny. Rescue me from the clutches of my enemies and my persecutors. Save me, O Lord, in your kindness. How great your goodness, O Lord, that you have in store for those who fear you, and wish towards those who take refuge in you, and show the sign of your children and the children of men. Save me, O Lord, in your kindness. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Blessed be the Virgin Mary, without thine one more is found, beneath the cross of the Lord. Hallelujah. Jesus, the Father and Mother, amazed at what was said of him. And Simeon blessed them, said to Mary, but behold, this child is destined to rise and fall of many in Israel. And be a sign that will be God's gift, and you yourself a serpent pierced, so that the thoughts of many hearts may be revealed. My brothers and sisters, Christ is the Feast of Our Lady of Sorrows. I was the pastor of Our Lady of Sorrows in Bernalillo, Mexico for 4 years. My favorite parish as a pastor. And so this feast day is very near and dear to me, and also because 6 years ago today, when the first Red Cross rescued from the towns of Parma was arrested. As a matter of fact, probably this time, 6 years ago, I was in a police car on my way to jail after doing a rescue that we all saved some babies' lives, so praise God for that. That brings us really to the significance of today. Our Lady of Sorrows, her heart was pierced, right? In other words, that was Sorrows, the Blessed Virgin Mary. Her heart was pierced by a sword, red sword of Sorrows, so he promised her that, right? Because, of course, she bore and gave birth to the child, destined for the fall and rise of many in Israel, silently contradicted, right? And that harkens back to Revelation chapter 12, Revelation chapter 12 says, Mary, a lady of sorrows, a lady of woman, I was pregnant with a child, a little girl, than I am alive, right? And child, and be destined for rise and fall of men in Israel, sign of the contradicted. And indeed, Mary's sorrows flow out as much as you were saved. In the mind of God from the beginning of salvation history, when the serpent tried to attack her and the child about to be born, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, she remained obedient, right? Perfectly obedient, Even in her sorrow, she never doubted, she never lost faith, she never lost the strength that she needed to be perfectly virtuous. The gospel, of course, interesting, I haven't done any formal research on this, but I am putting out the gospel first reading. I am pretty sure that this first reading is the most proclaimed first reading in all scripture. In other words, it's proclaimed more times than any other first reading in all of scripture. It's Hebrews chapter 5, verses 7 to 9, and it's so important because, it talks about Jesus, the Messiah, offering up prayers and supplications with bad cries and tears, he wept over the Jerusalem, he wept over all of our sinfulness, and he was saved from death, he suffered human death, of course, of being God, as he was heard by the Father, rose from the dead because of his reverence, because he not submitted himself to his Father in heaven, right? He was obedient, even unto death, the death on the cross, right? And he learned obedience from what he suffered. Now, this whole idea of learning obedience from what he suffered, okay? His obedience actually became perfected, even unto death, death on the cross. As a model for us in Thomas Aquinas, you'll hear me talk about this whole time, says that the significance of the cross is twofold, that it was offered forgiveness of our sins, but also as a model for how we should live, right? And Jesus became perfect in death. Perfect of the death on the cross, and doing so became the source of eternal salvation for all who obey him. Who follow him, who emulate him, who are willing to die in obedience, even to death on the cross, and being obedient even unto death. This was Mary, Blessed Virgin Mary. This was John the Baptist. This was Joseph, right? Nothing to dissuade them from their obedience. This was all saints, right? These saints understood the significance of obedience even unto death. Regardless, Mary's that's right, Mary, the dead Mary. And so this is the significance of this day, I think, that Mary suffered sorrows. We're going to suffer sorrows. These don't become excuses for us to become weak. They are actually reasons why and purpose are for us to become stronger and stronger and stronger in our faith, in our resolve, in our desire to be obedient. And of course, we have Christ's mercy. Right? We are indeed before short. Christ forgives us over and over and over again. So there's no excuse for us not persevering in this desire to be obedient, perfectly obedient. We have the ability to become perfectly obedient through Christ's mercy, through the sacrament of reconciliation, through the sacrament of the Eucharist. And this, I think, really is a day for us to honor the perseverance of the Blessed Virgin Mary, the perfect obedience of the Blessed Virgin Mary, and the sorrows of the Blessed Virgin Mary, that really are manifestations of her perfect trust in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, her perfect obedience. So, my little brothers and sisters, in Christ, let's reflect on that, let's reflect on our need for Christ's mercy, but also let's give thanks for the grace that our Lord gives us. And in spite of sorrow, trials, and tribulations in our lives, He gives us the means by which we can achieve perfection and obedience and our eternal salvation. Let us now ask our Father in heaven to show us